the Asian Games. Yeah. It's just going to be tougher, right? The standards are going to be higher with the Chinese in there, the Japanese in there, the Indonesians.
Of course, compared to Commonwealth Games, yes, it's going to be much, much tougher. But we've played most of them, so I don't think it should be new to us.
And again, you're going to be partnering with Ashwini.
Ashwini, of
right?
course. Yeah.
Do you have ever any misunderstandings on court, either personal or professional?
No, not at all. Me and Ashwini are very good friends. We're like pals. And we shop together, we hang out with each other, we hang out with each other's friends and family. You know, our families are very good friends.
Now, you're not someone who minces words at all. Tell me this claim of the Commonwealth Games being bigger than the Beijing Olympics. Do you think it was, and do you think it will compare to the Asian Games now?
I don't think we should compare it with any of the other games. I think Commonwealth Games in India was unique, I would say, but Olympics is much
unique,
bigger.
Unique good or unique bad?
Good and bad a little bit, you know. I felt that, you know, it could have been a little more cleaner.
And what about the Asian Games?
Asian Games is much bigger and much better than the Olympics, so I'm really excited.
Okay, so we have a few tweets now. Srikriti wants to know, how didn't you get media attention till now? You could have given Sania Mirza stiff competition in the ad world.
I don't know. Because as I said, you know, we were not promoted at all by associations. Not at all.
And so what do you live off? Do you live off your parents still? Because badminton is definitely not a well-paid sport.
I have a good job. You know, I'm with BPCL. And yeah, I have earned a lot of, you know, from badminton. I'm from a good family, so it's okay.
Okay.
You're managing.
You're managing with a BMW there parked outside. You're not just managing, okay? I wouldn't call that managing. Rimi2983 wants to know, will Gutta be able to sustain her game like Saina Nehwal or get lost in the celeb jungle like Sania Mirza?
No, as I said, you know, whoever I'll be signing with, I've told them very clearly that badminton is going to be my top priority no matter what. So, I hope to stay in limelight for badminton, nothing else.
Now, badminton is becoming quite a glamorous sport and they've sort of, you know, made the skirts shorter. People are making an effort to look good because it's more televised. How difficult is it to remain glamorous on the court?
I always wore skirts, you know. I think it's been 10 years since I've been wearing skirts. Now people are noticing, I guess, because of my Commonwealth gold. I always felt that as a sports person and when people are watching you play, it's my duty to be dressed well and to represent my sport in a very nice way, which people would like it. And that's what I do. And
I mean, you're naturally very pretty. So do you have to then think about, okay, I'll make my hair like this. I'll put a little makeup on that's sweatproof and things
no,
like that.
No, I don't put on makeup at
you
all.
You can't, right?
I don't put makeup. And I just think of dressing well. That's my only thing. Nothing else.
How many years do you think you have left? You're 27 now.
Yeah.
Which is sort of, you know, halfway through your career, would you say, or towards the end?
I think I'm just reaching my peak because, you know, Indians tend to reach
peak later,
peak a little later, you know. And Saina, well, you know, she's an exception, you know, she's got a lot of support, you know. She's been very lucky, I would say, you know, and I think she should.
Would you say that you've made as many sacrifices as she's made? Because she talks about how she's never touched, like, you know, sweet in her life, that she's woken up at 4 in the morning to go far away to play. She's had, like, amazing support from her family, not that much funding. So would you say that you have gone through those adversities as well?
I have gone through a lot also. You know, I used to live about 13 kilometers away from here. And in Hyderabad, 13 kilometers is pretty far. You know, not as in Bombay or Delhi. Get up at 4 o'clock, you know, come here, practice. Then I used to travel in the buses. My dad's salary was 5,000 rupees and he was the only earning person in my family then. And our house rent was 5,000 rupees. So yeah, we have gone through a lot, you know.